long day ahead in Philippine politics as the 19th Congress opens its second regular session this morning, ahead of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s second State of the Nation address. Let's get an update at the Batasang Pambansa in Quezon City from ABS-CBN's Archie Cruz. Go ahead, Archie.
Hi, Kat. Amid tight security here at the Batasang Pambansa complex, the second regular session of the 19th Congress is expected to open at 10 a.m. today. The two groups from the home district of the Speaker, Martin Romualdez, are expected to play a prominent role in that opening. The Sinirangan Chamber Singers is expected to lead the singing of the national anthem at 10 a.m., while the doxology will be done by the I Love Tacloban Band. And the Speaker is expected to preside over the opening and set the tone for rallying his colleagues in an opening speech, which is expected to set forth the plans for the second regular session. Expected to be on top of the agenda are the timely passage of the annual deliverable of Congress, the national budget for 2024, as well as the 20 LEDAC priorities, which both houses committed to pass by end of 2023. The 20, very briefly, are the amendments to the BOT law, the National Disease Prevention Authority, the Internet Transactions and E-commerce Law, the Medical Reserve Corps, the Virology Institute of the Philippines, mandatory ROTC, revitalizing the salt industry, Valuation Reform, E-Governance Act, the ease of paying taxes, the National Government Resizing Program, the Unified System of Separation, Retirement and Pension of Military and Uniform Personnel, the LGU Income Classification, the Waste to Energy Bill, the Philippine Passport Act, the Magna Carta for Filipino Seafarers, amendments to the Anti-Agricultural Smuggling Act, the amendments to the Bank Secrecy Law, the Anti-Financial Scamming Act, and the National Employment Action Plan. 16 of these have already been approved by the House, which means only 4 more need action from this chamber. These are the National Rightsizing Program, the Unified System of Separation, Retirement, and Pension of MUPs, the National Employment Action Plan, and the amendments to the Anti-Agricultural Smuggling Act. Overall, the 19th Congress ended the first regular session with only 6 out of the then 42 priorities hurdling both houses. The priority list has grown to 44 as of the last LEDAC meeting last July 5, and the list is expected to go further as the President is expected to deliver his second State of the Nation address later today. Apart from an accounting of the past year and the laying out of the vision for the next, SONAS are also an opportunity for the Chief Executive to add to that priority list of bills. Over 2,000 guests are expected to troop to the Batasang complex later today to listen to the SONA. The President will deliver the speech in a joint session with the Senate. Among the VIPs expected are the Vice President Sara Duterte and the remaining former presidents, Joseph Estrada, Gloria Arroyo, and Rodrigo Duterte, as well as members of the diplomatic corps, the cabinet, and the captains of industry. Lara Maige, a classically trained soprano, will sing the national anthem just before the SONA in the afternoon session. COVID-19 protocols for SONA guests this year will be minimal as they will only be required to present their vaccination card during the screening, but those unvaccinated will have to present a negative RT-PCR test 24 hours before the event. The proceedings on this today will be under a hybrid setup, meaning teleconferencing would still be allowed. And as for the 2024 budget, the Speaker said Sunday that the House will aim to approve the proposed 5.768 trillion 2024 national budget before their first recess in October. And of course, we are expecting the Speaker in about an hour to be here at the main lobby of the Batasang Pambansa to open the LED features at the lobby, which will show the gallery of members of the 19th Congress House of Representatives. Kat?
RG, over the weekend, House Speaker Ferdinand Martin Romualdez gave several details, a sort of teaser as to what we should expect during the President's second State of the Nation address. Do we have any word as to how long will it be? We heard that it might be one of the shortest in history.
You know what? It's, you know, before every SONA, there's always a lot of speculation about how long the speech would be. And you know that in the past, we've had very long speeches that take almost 3 hours. So it's actually quite hard to speculate. And all of these inside information supposedly would be only indicative. And the president always reserves the right to edit his speech, even his or her speech, even as he delivers it. There will be times when he may choose not to skip a part of the, or to skip a part of the prepared speech. So I really wouldn't speculate how much or how long the speech would be.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, our veteran House reporter, RG Cruz. Let's head now to the Senate to check on the preparations there for the opening of the second regular session. ABS-CBN's Sherry Ann Torres joins us live for an update. Go ahead, Sherry Ann.
Yes, Katrina, compared to last year when the public waited with bated breath as to who will be the next president under the 19th Congress, this time talks about a supposed move to unseat Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri were immediately quelled, with majority of the senators claiming or declaring their full support to Zubiri. These even as Zubiri in previous interviews already said that he will abide by the wishes of his colleagues if they will feel that it's about time for him to be replaced by somebody else. At 10 in the morning today, Katrina, the Senate will open its first day of second regular session, to be followed by a roll call and adoption of the so-called ceremonial resolutions, specifically the resolution informing the House of Representatives and the President that the Senate is now in session. Another resolution will be passed for the holding of a joint session, and the last one creating a joint notification committee that will inform the President that Congress is ready to hear his second State of the Nation address later at 4 this afternoon. Meantime, part of the session will be Senate President Zubiri's opening speech, where he is expected to lay down the direction and targets of the chamber in the second regular session. The Senate will afterwards suspend the session for the senators to proceed to the Batasan Pambansa complex to hear the President's second SONA. From the Senate's end, Zubiri has already committed the passage of the Marcos Jr. administration's priority bills before the Christmas break this year. Included in the list are the bills of the Public-Private Partnership Act, creation of the National Disease Prevention Management Authority, Cybersecurity Act, the mandatory ROTC program, and the bill revitalizing the salt industry. Zubiri, in previous interviews, have also underlined his intention to pass the 150 peso across the board daily wage hike for private sector workers. Meantime, still hours before the President's second SONA, a number of senators have already issued some reminders to the chief executive. They include Senator Francis Escudero, who stressed that a SONA is not just about reporting, but a piece that should also serve as an eye-opener and a disclosure of the truth about the real state of the nation. Senate Minority Leader Aquilino Pimentel is also hoping to hear the so-called real state of the nation report from the President, and that his message will be one that is fully or that will be fully understood by the Filipino masses, and that his message will carry his concrete plans to alleviate the plight of the poor or the poor, the agricultural sector, and an explanation as to why Philippine offshore gaming operators are still here. Katrina, Senator Jingo Estrada, meantime, is hoping or looking forward to a more pronounced reporting about what his administration is doing about the West Philippine Sea issue. Senators and their guests are expected to start arriving here at around 8 in the morning. And as expected, security arrangements here today is very tight, and only those with invitation and accredited journalists are allowed to come here or to enter the Senate premises. Katrina.
Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Sherry Ann Torres.